95% of the people being tortured actually are not political prisoners, they're just everyday people. Torture is the cheapest form of investigation.
Here in Davos, I met the founder of International Bridges to Justice. What does your organization do?
International Bridges to Justice is committed to ending torture as an investigative tool by placing lawyers at an early stage in police stations and courtrooms in the 93 countries that have already passed laws but are not yet able to implement the laws due to a lack of training and resources.
And organizations are also like Amnesty International, and I assume also you and do similar things. What is your special approach?
I think it's really different in that International Bridges to Justice is not just a campaign, and it's not an organization that is looking at what happens in torture after the fact. A lot of human rights organizations focus on collecting the facts and also the prosecution of people who torture, which is a huge part of the puzzle as well. However, our focus is in the prevention of torture. And we realize that in order to prevent torture, it's been statistically proven, and we've seen it in the projects that we work in, that early access to counsel is the difference between someone being tortured and not tortured. What's happened today is that, unfortunately, torture is the cheapest form of investigation. And so for basic cases, in basic criminal cases, if you're too poor to afford a lawyer, unfortunately, you're not going to get protection, you're not going to get counsel, and it's going to be problematic.
And how exactly do you work? You train lawyers and also policemen. I want to learn a little bit more about exactly how you work.
There are different pieces. As I mentioned earlier, there are 93 countries that have already passed laws, and each country is at a different stage. So what we do is we come in and we work with the lawyers on the ground to find out exactly what they have and what the gaps may be in the existing system so that we can help the country move forward in providing early access to counsel.
And also in the way that you work within your organization, with the energy, and you also have a special approach with that. Can I learn about that?
Yes. I mean, I think one of the main pieces is that we also recognize the fact that although sometimes there's the good guys and the bad guys, that oftentimes it's not really that black and white. For example, what we realize is that although much of the world seems to focus on political prisoners, 95% of the people being tortured actually are not political prisoners. They're just everyday people who may have stolen a bicycle or may be caught up in a situation where they've been picked up by the police, and not having access to counsel is really the critical difference. So I think part of it is that we really recognize the fact that there's a lot that we can do besides polarizing the debate between the good and the bad, and that we can really encourage the spirit of light to move forward and through the world through these ways.
Today here in Davos, I just witnessed
the dragon.
Yes, the dragon. So what was this about?
It is the year 2012, and it is again the year of the dragon. International Bridges to Justice was born and founded in the year 2000, and we spent the last 12 years putting together the pieces of the program so that we can see throughout the world that it is possible for us to really achieve our dreams. So in the next 12 years, what we recognize is that in the year of the dragon, there's a special energy, a special power. The female version of the dragon is actually the phoenix. The phoenix rises from the ashes of destruction. So in many of the countries where we work, where in Burundi, Rwanda, Cambodia, many of these countries are really rising from the ashes of destruction, rebuilding their legal system in order to safeguard the people in their countries. And we just are very excited that this is a really particularly potent and powerful time for us to allow this potentiality.
And besides funding, how can people that watch this video can help you? What support do you need?
Okay. Well, I would say besides funding, because even something as small as, like, today they talked about $5 donations or $25 donations, make a difference if you're able to give something and also spread the word to your friends and to different people to say, okay, we can spread this word energetically in different ways. When the whole world comes together, we really are looking at this not only as lawyers who can come together and help us train and put together training materials, but consultants who can help us with business plans, people involved in the media who can spread our message, people involved in development and fundraising, any part of it. You look at every person in the world and you see that we each have a gift that we can give to humanity, and it's just bringing your gift forward to make it happen and looking at the fact that these dreams are possible if we all decide to do it together.